Hi. Whenever I put up a video about controlling your dog in the park so that he doesn't just run up to random dogs and charge up to random people completely out of your control, most people will say, I feel exactly the same thing, Rob. This is what I've been saying for ages. It drives me mad. It's my pet hate, etc., etc. But there'll always be a percentage of people who say, well, if your dog's aggressive, you shouldn't bring him to the park. If your dog doesn't like people running up to it, you shouldn't come to the park. My dog should be free. This is his time to enjoy himself and do whatever he likes. And I absolutely get, in theory, why you think that should be the case. But there are several problems with this. One is, it's against the law. The law makes it an obligation for you to have your dog under control in any public place. So the moment your dog starts running over to me and you call it and it doesn't respond, or I ask you to call it and you cannot call it away, you're already breaking the law. And under the Dangerous Dogs Act now, you can be prosecuted for that, whether your dog's intentions are friendly or not friendly, whether he touches me or doesn't touch me. So I think for that reason alone, we should work harder at controlling our dogs and keeping them on the lead if we can't. But there are also some other repercussions. And I just want those of you who would leave your dogs loose to run up to everyone while shouting, it's all right, he's friendly. There are some things I would like you to consider about that. Now, if somebody takes their dog to the park and is keeping on the lead, there'll be a reason why they're choosing to do that. It may simply be that their dog also doesn't recall. But it may be things like maybe their dog is really fearful of other dogs. And so they keep their dog on the lead because they're trying to make sure it feels safe. And they're worried that if another dog comes running over, it might bolt. So what happens? They keep their dog on a lead and they stay right over there as far away from everyone as possible. And what they're saying is, I'm prepared to sacrifice the whole of the park. I'm going to give you the entire park, except this one little bit, just the bit that my lead encompasses, just so that your dog or my dog feels safe. And you will say, no, you're not even having that one bit of the park. I want that bit too. And my dog has to have that bit too. And if you're not okay with that, go home. I personally think that's pretty selfish. You've got the whole rest of the park. So usually I find the people that let that happen, it's actually because they can't stop their dog from running over. It's not that they want to make your life difficult, but they have no control over their dog. And rather than taking responsibility for it and saying, I'm not going to let it off the lead until it comes back, they just foist it on everybody. But also, that dog may be really aggressive. He may attack a dog that comes near. So the owner is saying, I'm going to keep my dog with me so that he can't hurt your dog. Now be clear. If that person has their dog on the lead over there and your dog runs over and their dog attacks your dog, if it ever ended up in court, you'd be the one who's likely to be found guilty because their dog was under their control. And I know what you'll think is, yes, but their dog should have had a muzzle on if it's that aggressive. If their dog's on a lead, it doesn't need to have one. It's your dog that ran over to their dog, and had your dog not run over to theirs, the incident wouldn't have happened. So you find when you get in court, the judge finds in their favour, not yours. And there have been many cases where this has happened. So they don't have an obligation to have their dog on a lead and muzzle. If you can't recall your dog, the obligation is on you to have it on the lead. And that's just being fair. That's just being fair to everybody else. But I meet many dogs whose dogs are aggressive towards other dogs. And it was often caused by dogs like that, who the owner said, it's all right, he's perfectly friendly, but they've got a young puppy and your dog ran over and started jumping all over it and frightened the life out of it. Remember, when that puppy first comes out for its walk, the only dogs it knows that exists are its family, its mother and its siblings. So it's a Cocker Spaniel. And it's never met any dogs before who weren't a Cocker Spaniel. The owner takes it to the park and a German Shepherd comes running over and the puppy goes, what's that? I don't even know. And suddenly it's pinned to the floor by this German Shepherd who's only playing with it. Doesn't mean any harm at all. But can you imagine how scary that is for this puppy? So by the time the owner tries to rescue it and pick it up or do whatever, and you're going, it's all right, he's friendly, that puppy may already be traumatized and now thinks, I don't like big black and tan dogs with pointy ears. But anyway, the owner moves on. And then they meet a Dalmatian who does exactly the same thing. And the owner's going, it's all right, he's friendly. How many of those interactions do you think that puppy will need before he decides, actually, I don't think I like other dogs at all? And many of you who'll be watching this who have dog aggressive dogs will say, I can remember exactly the situation that caused my dog to become fearful. And it'll always be when he was young, some dog did this. It may not have been aggressive, but it was fearful nonetheless. or fear-inducing nonetheless. I want you to imagine that puppy's scenario, but as a human being. So you're walking down the street, you're minding your own business, and I come charging up to you. And I start saying, it's all right, I'm friendly, but I'm touching you and I'm running my hands all over you. I'm putting my nose in places where you probably wouldn't want my nose put, but I keep saying, it's okay, I'm friendly. How are you gonna feel about that? Now I want you to imagine two of my friends came over and started doing the same thing. So there are now three of us doing that. And I'm saying to you, it's all right, I'm friendly. It's all right, we're friendly. It's all right, we won't hurt you. I don't imagine for one second that would make you feel any better. Now I want you to imagine that happens tomorrow and the next day and the next day. How long would it be before you didn't even want to leave the house? And that's what happens with other dogs. So to that percentage of people who still stubbornly insist that as long as their dog is friendly, he should have the freedom of the park, I think you're the sort of people who should get prosecuted and somebody should force you to take control of your own dog. If you can't control it, keep it on a lead. Take it to a good Prama trainer, positive reinforcement and minimally aversive trainer who will help teach you how to teach your dog so that you can let it off the lead. And if I say, excuse me, can you call your dog away, please? You can call him and he comes away. Every dog owner should be able to do that. And if you don't or you can't, then it's your obligation to try and do something to fix that. Have a good day.